So let's talk about line spacing and paragraph spacing in Pages. I see this a lot when people are using word processors. They want to have some division between their paragraphs. So they put a blank line between the paragraphs. So for instance, the paragraphs would really be like that, but they just add this extra line in there. So every paragraph here has got an extra line. But that's not the best way to do it. So let me show you the best way. Let's say I have no extra lines between any of these paragraphs. I'm going to select them all. I'm going to go to Format. And under Format, I can go under Spacing here. And there's before paragraph and after paragraph. So I can add a certain number of points. Let's say 10 points between the paragraphs. And you can see it looks very similar. But there's no extra line here. I'm here at the end of this sentence. I forward arrow once and I'm at the beginning of the next one. If I add a new paragraph, I didn't have to add an extra line there. And best of all, I have complete control over the spacing. I can select all again and I can decide I want a little bit more spacing or I want a little less spacing. So adding before paragraph or after paragraph spacing is the best way to get divisions between your paragraphs. Now in addition to that, you may want to change the line spacing as well. They're kind of related items, and I can select all here and you can see under spacing I've got lines, and I can increase and say I want 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, and you can see that the lines themselves, even inside of paragraphs, change. And I can also set it to be at least, exactly, or between. So I, for instance, I can say at least and a certain number of points. And why at least? Well, if I have different font sizes in there, it'll make sure that if I've got small fonts, there's still going to be at least 16 points. But if it's a larger font, it's still going to expand that. So for instance, here if I would change this one paragraph and make it, say, a very large text, you see that it actually is larger line spacing there because it's a larger font. But it's going to be at least 16 points. So you can do exactly and exactly 16 points. Let me select all and change it to exactly 16. Now if I were to increase the font size here, you can see it's all squished together because it's going to be 16 point line spacing even though it's 30 point text there. You also can do between, which means it's going to put a certain number of points between each line. So 0 would be normal, whereas, or actually 1 is the minimum. You can do 2, you can do 3, but if I were to increase the font size here, it would still have that many points between each line. So this allows you to do it. And of course you can do that on a paragraph by paragraph basis. So I'm just undoing here at the beginning. I could say I want this paragraph to have bigger line spacing, this paragraph to use at least line spacing, you know, this paragraph to use exactly line spacing. And each one of these, you can see as you select the paragraph, changes it here. The same thing is true with paragraph spacing. So if I wanted, say, these three paragraphs here to have a little more space after them, I can increase paragraph spacing. And there's 20 points after these, but that was what I had selected. These paragraphs have 10 points after it. So you can do it on a paragraph by paragraph basis. So if you want a little more division between this paragraph and the next paragraph, you can simply increase the space after that paragraph.